the message to go across very strongly about an acknowledgement, about an awareness, about the empowerment which we do for the women. So we have a lot of Nightingales here who are listening to us, you know, so you know, they do a brilliant job, you know, in terms of, you know, because when we are in the hospital bed, our life, by and large, after the doctor, lies with them. I'm a diabetic patient, you know, sometimes, you know, my HbA1c goes up to 2.2 because, you know, my pancreas is bad. So when I go there, you know, and then when I go to the doctor, will come for the round visits. It is with them, you know, in terms of, you know, Nightingales with hands. So the message has to pass across. You know, so we are grateful to have a lot of celebrities here. We have got Bhagyashree, who doesn't need any introduction. You know, just, you know, if I say "Mene pyar kiya, kisse pyar kiya," so you know that is how, you know, Bhagyashree is here, and she's also, and you know, that was news to me. You know that she is a certified nutritionist, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, you know, so she understands health science a little bit more than from the celebrity point of view. So welcome, Bhagyashree, to this event. Thank you for coming. We have so I've done Bhagyashree, and you know, I'm going to speak about a little bit about Payal Ghosh. So she's from Calcutta, and she studied political science, and that's quite interesting, you know, and political science and then a movie. And so she has done her Hollywood debut, she has done Telugu movies, she has done other movies, you know, she has done BBC telefilm, if I'm not mistaken. So I'm just, you know, so I just did the reference, you know, but I still recollect, you know, so welcome, Payal, you know, thank you for, you know, listening. We have Miss Earth here. And Alankrita, you know, thank you for being here. So, you know, Alankrita is just doing her Bollywood debut with a movie called Bombay is known for its square feet. And it is Love per Square Feet is a movie, you know, which is getting released. Thank you for being here. And with Himanshu, I really don't know, he's a real daredevil guy, you know, because, you know, Khatron ka Kiladi, you know, so, you know, what all, you know, there's so much, you know, to speak about him. But he looks a very adorable boy, you know, from his face, Vajha Tum Ho. So, he's a romantic guy, and I think the women love to see a romantic guy on this day, you know, on the Women's Day. Thank you, Manju, for being here, you know, for this talk. So, now, the flow of the event is, you know, doctors will present, you know, their perspective on the Women's Day. Starting with Dr. Kiran Kohler, you know, who will present her few points, followed with Dr. Shelter. And then we'll have a moderated session with the artist, you know, coming across to the stage and speaking about the event of it. Thank you, the stage is on. sorry, you know, we wanted a photo ops, you know, because, you know, with the full crowd, you know, we would like to have a photo with all the people together. Because all of us are busy, you know, so yeah.
Mitra,
thank you.
कुछ बोलेंगे नहीं
First and foremost, let me wish all of you a very, very happy Women's Day. We're all gathered here today at the Hinduja Hospital. And I've got some very eminent personalities right in front of me, Dr. Berry, Dr. Kiran, and Dr. Sharida. Thanks to them, we're all here. And we're definitely going to know more about what problems women of today actually face. Every one of you know me here as an actress who has Nandane Pyar Kiya, and it's been a long time, but during that time and now, there have been a certain amount of changes that have happened. And yes, I went on a path of a lot of learning. And let me introduce you, me to you in a different personality. I'm a certified nutritionist now, and I spent my entire last year and the year before that learning, studying a lot about how nutrition can really change your life of today, how we are all as women and men together faced with this complicated situation called stress, which in turn affects our bodies, which in turn starts off on different kind of medication, sends us down the road to illness and diseases. And it all has to do with what you're eating and what you're thinking, honestly. Yes, there are genetics involved. Yes, there are lifestyles involved. But a lot of it is changeable and a lot of it is in our hands. And today, as we stand here promoting this organization called SHE, which says self-help is everything, I would like to tell you that it is really simple. Help is in our hands. And doctors, I'm sure you would agree with me that lots of times that you meet patients, you tell them, ye dawai lo, lekin dhyan rakho, khud ka dhyan rakho. Bahut zaruri hai. Especially being Women's Day today, I would say, in our culture, in India, women are taught to give. We tend to look after our husbands, our families, our children, our homes, our careers, all of them before we look after the most important part, that's us. And I truly believe that happiness had I in the middle for a reason. That's because you are important. You should be the center of your universe. You are responsible for your smiles, again having I in the center. And that's what's really going to make you happy. That's really what's going to make you well. That's really what's going to take you through life. So I think very essentially, let me put a few things forward to you, all of us women here today. Dr. Yaa talked about PCODs being a lifestyle disease. Yes, it is a lifestyle disease. And for younger women and lots of women here today, I think that's very important because we are trying to conform to certain figures, certain weight loss programs, certain fad diets that you kind of download over the internet, and we say, "Achha, ye diet kaam karega. Ye dekho, meri friend ne itna vajan lose kiya. Ya so and so actress is looking so slim and sexy, and that's why I want to be like her." So you end up making all those changes which are very, very unnatural to your own body, to your own lifestyle, to your own requirement. Diet is a badly used word nowadays. Diet actually stands for a routine food plan. It does not mean you give up on food. It does not mean that you count your calories. It does not mean that you restrict yourself from eating anything that you really love to, because food and happiness are linked together. We in India meet people for social reasons over chai, coffee, khana. We celebrate our festivals, again, over khana, peena. And meeting people is so important, and food is the crux of all our social activities. So when we tell people, diet hai, aaj hum nahi kha sakte, we cut off our social interaction with all the people that will make us happy, will make us smile, and we create that stress in our life. So food and stress is interlinked in more ways than one. There's lots more to say, and I'm sure Dr. Shailja will go into the details here. But what I'd really like to say is, do not follow fad diets, because all of you are unique. Each and every one of you, your women, are unique in your own special way, and it does not make you less or to be in competition with anyone else. You yourself are unique and beautiful. You have to believe that in yourself. You have to learn to make yourself happy. You have to learn to take the decisions for your own good. And you can do that by understanding how you would like to live your life. It's not about size zero. It's not about a 24-inch waist. It's not even about so-called weight loss, because one woman can have heavier bone set than another. You can have a greater amount of fat in your body and lesser amount of muscle. Or you can have equal amount of muscle and lesser amount of fat, and both the women can weigh exactly the same. So it is so, so individual when you take decisions for what you are eating and how you lead your lifestyle. Well, I'm here to say that Bhagyashree now is not just the actress, but you're a nutritionist, and you're most welcome to help. Come to me for help, ask any questions that's needed. My website online is bhagyashreeonline.com, and you can connect with me through Back to Basics. So that's what I have to offer. And last of all, I'd like to say Happy Women's Day to all you beautiful women over here, and to all the supportive men, thank you so much for being here. It has been a total pleasure being amongst all of you. Thank you.
Women, anything in particular?
Everyone's so well equipped. Everyone's a happy set of people here.
There's one question. There's one request from Himanshu for a picture.
Okay. All right. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Thank you for having me.
Yes. I've been big fans. I definitely.
Yeah. Dr. Shandri, you can take over the seat once the machine leaves.
No, you just.
Like I said, very easy. All the aching arms, which you just have to edit it.
Recording नहीं हो रहा
है.
Wait. Excuse me. Ma'am, यहाँ पे. Ma'am, start from here. Ma'am, last corner.
Ma'am, here. Ma'am, here. Bhagyashree, ma'am, here. Come here, ma'am. Here.
Ma'am, here.
All points down. You
having to
do? Thank you.
I'm having a better life.
Thank you.
वो शूट ही नहीं हुआ.
अरे भाई ले यार,
शूट ही नहीं हुआ.
भाग्यश्री मैडम यहाँ लौकर
लौकर जायते अजून एक थोड़ा खाली है.
बस बस
बस इकडे इकडे भाग्यश्री मॅम इकडे
काय ऍक्शन
हा विक्ट्री करा.
थँक्यू
बाय बाय.
Oh, that's okay. It's a pleasure. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Very important chapter in our lives, in our country today. How many of us are absolutely ashamed of our vessels? We women are told, kapde aise mat pehno, baal aise mat banao, ye mat khao, wo mat karo. Why? Why is that women have to think 10 times about what the neighbor's cat is going to think about them, what the neighbor's brother will think about them? What I'm talking about is that women need to empower each other. The biggest problem in our country could be the government facilities, could be the lack of education, sensitization. The three most important things, we're not educated enough. Though we have 945 females for 1,000 males in our country, and half of the women are not educated. We don't have health facilities. So the first and the foremost thing is that we need to bring about change by creating a venues where women have the access to health and sanitation. Aap mein se sabka jab periods aate hain, I'll be very honest. How many of you don't go to the temples, gurudwaras, churches, don't do yoga, don't go to the gym for the first 2 days? Please raise your hands. How many of you do not go when you have your periods to these holy places and condemn yourselves because you have periods, you're not supposed to go to the church, you're not supposed to go to the gurudwara, you're not supposed to eat non-veg, you're not supposed to do yoga. Yes, a headstand, of course, not because you're bleeding. But who all really go through this every day, every month? How many of you, please raise your hands. And you tell your daughters the same thing, and your mother-in-laws tell you the same thing. The most important thing for me is that women, could be your mother-in-law, could be your mother, could be your sister, needs to uplift you. When you marry into another family with a different set of value systems, aapko unke hisab se jeena padta hai. आपको अपना घर छोड़ के जहाँ पे आप एक वैल्यू सिस्टम से जीते हैं वो छोड़ के आप किसी दूसरे के घर में जाते हैं जहाँ पे यू एम्बाइब ऑन देयर कल्चर वैल्यूज एंड देयर सिस्टम्स. माय पॉइंट इज व्हाई कैन वुमेन सपोर्ट ईच अदर. द मोस्ट बेसिक थिंग इज मैं यहाँ बैठी हूँ. आई वुड से शी इज सच अ बिच, शी इज दिस, शी इज दैट. वी कंडेम ईच अदर बाय नेम कॉलिंग. दैट्स द फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट थिंग. हम एक दूसरे के बारे में बिचिंग करते हैं तो हम एक दूसरे को अपलिफ्ट कैसे कर सकते हैं? हेल्थ, education, sanitation comes way later when there is no respect amongst women for each other. So my point is, from today, I want you all to start respecting each other. Stop name-calling each other. Stop categorizing each other. Do not body shame. Now we talk about women saying, ye moti hai, ye patli hai, ye gori hai, ye kali hai. I'm an actor, right? So I'll tell you when I go for a casting or a meeting or an audition. The messages we get. Indians who look like foreigners, foreigners who look like Indians, girls who are not too fat and chubby, on the fairer side of the skin tone. Now tell me, what is this? Is this discrimination to what level? is this discrimination of any kind? We actors face it all the time. Models face it all the time. Oh, she's short. She's not tall enough. So what you feel is you feel you're not worthy. You feel you're not worthy of that love, the attention, the opportunity. You think your talent is not that important because you're discriminated on the basis of how you look, on the basis of how you dress. Now, if someone's probably sitting here and I see her bra strap, the first thing we notice is, oh my God, she's showing her bosom, she's showing her bra strap. How indecent is this girl? It could be by mistake. It could be through your buttons I can see your bra. You don't do it purposely, do you? You don't do it purposely, but the fact is the way we are predominantly thinking about each other is about the fact that we are indecent women if we show our legs, we are indecent if we show our bosom, which is the most natural part of our body. Back in the days, women used to wear the saris and blouses. I'm sure India is very famous for Kama Sutra, but women and their sexuality is condemned in our country. Why? Why are women condemned on the basis of their sexuality? Are we not sexual human beings? Do we not like to be loved? We are the basic biological sources of creating in the world. We create, we generate, we nurture. So this same, for example, we are very, very scared. We live in fear. The most important thing is how we overcome our fear. Hum ye dar ke jeete ki acha main, now we have PCOS. I suffered from this problem. I was super stressed. I was probably going to every dermatologist because I was not aware that I could probably have this problem. So I was breaking out. I was very young, but I was super stressed because of my, you know, my degrees, my work. I want to do this, I want to do that, I want to be an IFS officer. I was stressed about everything in my life, and then I was breaking out. I did not have facial hair growth, but I did break out, and I was completely devastated. My beauty, I thought, as women we think, hamari shakal bigad gayi hai. Now I'm not beautiful anymore. I'm going to be despised by the society. Nobody's going to like me. What's going to happen to my future? Everything's going to go to the drain. So the first and foremost thing is stop Googling, because Google always tells you you're going to die. The first thing you Google is it leads to cancer, it leads to something. So the most important thing is you seek help. The most important thing is stop Googling, doing your own researches and analysis and taking prescriptions, self-medicating yourself, which is the worst thing you can do. I went to a dermatologist and they gave me some few medicines because they thought, you know, I'm young, I'm sprouting, you know, it could be a hormonal imbalance which could not be PCOD. So I tried every medicine because I was scared to go to a gynecologist when I was really young. And I don't know what's going to happen there. I mean, I don't want to be opening up my body's vital parts in front of a stranger. But that doctor is there to help you. She's there, she's educated, has a medical background to help you. So do not be embarrassed if it's a man or a woman. If you're more comfortable with the opposite sex or you're not, it's solely your call. But I urge you, if you are suffering mentally, emotionally, physically, you have to seek help. Do not think, what will your parents or your husband or your brother say to you? Because your source of happiness and life comes from you. If you are depressed and you are sick and you're not happy, how do you think you're going to make anyone else in your family happy? How do you think you're going to go back home and give your children love? They think as long as you're not married, you're absolutely this young girl who needs to take care of herself. Jaisi shaadi ho jaati hai, responsibilities come and you forget yourself. We women forget ourselves because we are givers. We are nurturers. We believe that we are. To be very honest, we live in a patriarchal society in our country. But who really runs the world? Our women. So why are we so ashamed of our bodies? We need to get over the first thing is stop fearing to seek help. Do not be ashamed of your vessel. You could be fat, thin. In your head, make sure you love yourself, because self-love is so important today that without self-love, there is nothing. No one's going to love you if you don't love yourself, because what happens is you have no confidence in yourself. And when you have no confidence, there is no progress. That's one part. The most important thing I say, because we're talking about she, self-help is everything. The first thing you guys should do is go back home. Think, what is it that I'm actually suffering from? Even if you're not suffering, it's brilliant, it's beautiful if you're so happy and content with yourself. Physically, please do checkups. Mentally and emotionally, women are the most fragile beings. You know how emotionally and mentally things affect our bodies more than our health? which is medically claimed that if you're not emotionally, mentally taking care of yourself, it really harms a woman's body. Now, when you're going to be pregnant, the things you feed your baby, the kind of thoughts you think, how positive you are, your child, you know, imbibes every little tiny detail. You're a reflection of your energy. So if your energy is not going to be the way you want it to be for your baby, for yourself, for your lives, you're going to be a very unhappy person. So if a car breaks down, what do you guys do? Do you throw the car away? Do you kick it? Do you keep watching the car? What do? You take it to a garage, right? You take it to fix it. Now, if your body is ailing, do not hesitate. Please go forward to any doctor for that matter. Now, our country suffers because women are not educated on the basis of oral contraceptives in the rural areas. We have about so many kids in their families, and they keep reproducing, and their health keeps deteriorating. How much can a woman's body take? So it's time to...
Questions, you know, for the wonderful speech, you know, from my brother.
Any questions, personally, mentally, emotionally, anything?
I see a lot of courage. I see a lot of strength in your conversation. When you're articulating yourself. So it comes from a lot of experience. You know, sometimes, you know, courage is after outgoing fear. How much courage is, you know, what is this?
So my mom is a very courageous woman. She has had a really terrible family life, like I would say. Not her, like, she's had, my family is wonderful, my parents are amazing. But you know, sometimes what happens is you could be a good kid, but you couldn't have good parents always. You know, we think parents are gods, we think parents, but they're human beings at the end of the day. They're you individuals, where they're good and they're bad. So I think I get the courage from her, and when I was wanting to come into this industry, my grandfather passed away, and he was the closest to me, and you know, because he was a bureaucrat. Is something that I wanted to do. So I remember when the first time I got an opportunity to give an audition. Someone picked me up from the street and said, you know what, Alanka, why don't you come audition? Me? Have you seen me? No. And so I kind of got dressed and I wore a spaghetti. Okay? A spaghetti is a strap like this. And I was going to go out of the house and someone from my family, I will not name them, comes up to me and says, do you want to be Jennifer Lopez and Britney Spears wearing those clothes? And my mom, I was really young, okay, and I was in school. And I didn't do that at that point of time because my mom was like, finish your studies, get educated, and then do whatever. Because it's very important that we all are financially independent. You never know when someone leaves you. So at the end of the day, so I was disheartened by the fact that I thought that I was wearing something really indecent and, you know, there's something wrong with me or my body. And I was growing up and, you know, I had boobs and, you know, I started to wear a bra. So when my aunt said that to me, my mom has been so good to me that she's protected me. You know, sometimes you have to protect yourself from the people who are within your family than the outer world. Sometimes they emotionally damage you more than anything in the world. Outside world does not matter if the people in your house try to put you down. So I remember, it was years later when I became Miss India Earth and I went internationally. They were fuming and jealous and they tried to do everything to put me down. They made fake blogs, fake identities, fake pages, rumors, and you know, all the things women have to face is rumors. What is the biggest setback for women? Rumors, what people talk behind their back, what's going on? Oh my God, we all want to be respected. But we think if people talk about us, that is disrespect. But that is not, because rumors is not news. Gossip is not news, it does not define you. So while I was, you know, starting my career, I had so much of animosity from people, my extended family, that it would always make me cry and put me down. But my dad and my mom were so strong that they protected me against every emotional or physical remark that they would make. So that's why I'm telling you, emotional and physical and mental strength is so important. You can be lanky, but if this works, it's so important. So my family has nurtured me and protected me against people who tried to put me down and were jealous of me, hated me, wanted to see me fail. People want to see you fail when you succeed. They will come up with things to put you down. So that's the kind of courage I got from my parents, my dad and my mom, who are amazing people. And I think without them, I would not be standing here and talking about women empowerment, because I empowered myself through my mother. So I want you guys to empower each other through everything possibly you can do, because it's very important that we stand together united. Because if we stand together, the men will follow us, because they know if we're given the power that they have,
we're going to really make this world a better place, which probably they don't want. But I think you should just work towards each other's happiness and goals and do not live in fear. Because fear only makes you go lower than what you really deserve in your life. So do not live in fear, because I don't live in fear even today. Of anything that might come, I might fail. I might not make it big, I might. But at least try. Try to be the person you really are, because that's the most important thing you can do.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot from Hinduja
Healthcare
Surgical, as well as
Thank you so much for having me. It's a pleasure to be here. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. I request Payal to come up and leave a message in before. Himanshu is a man today, so we can be able to.
I'm gonna say something very different, not much. Good afternoon, everyone, and happy Women's Day to every woman here and women around the world. Thanks to Shubhamya, Doc Plum, and Hinduja Healthcare for inviting me. I'm honored and glad. I have been brought up in a world where my parents have girls and boys are given equal importance, yet I'm aware that it is not the same everywhere. For instance, my household would seek money for her children's education, but not spend a little on herself for medication. I was only aware she was very ill, did not get to know how much she was suffering. This is not just a one story, it is the way many Indian women suffer, and I, along with DOC Plus and Hinduja Healthcare, want to make a difference. We want women of India to take the matter in their hands and take care of us, because clearly no one else is going to do the job for you. Recently, I was getting wet and was getting acne. My doctor said, could be PCOS, PCOD, you must go and check. I got scared. Oh my God, I'm only 27 and I'm going to get all this. It happens, there's nothing to worry about. Well, I went to doctor. Before going, I was getting all panic attacks. I'm thinking that, okay, I may get this. So they were like cooling me down and said, don't worry. I mean, everything was fine, thankfully, touch wood. But then I was really worrying, like, I exercise every day. I eat well, means whatever I need to eat according to my dietitian. Still, why am I not losing weight? And I think from size zero, suddenly started getting away. So these are all the things which really comes in my mind. And I see because it is me and I love myself to any extent. So I do think that, I'll go to a doctor, I'll do my regular checkup. Every 6 months, I do my insulin checkup, CBC. CRP, liver profile, everything I check every 6 months. But other women, they don't. They are urban people. They just leave about the remote villages. Even urban people, they are so busy with their own lives, with their kids, with their work, that they don't even get to go to the doctors for health checkup. They ignore them. And when it comes to something very bad, that thing they are forced to go, and doctors have nothing to do with. Because that must have gone to the last stage of ovarian cancer or something like that. Even if they're discharged, white discharge, which smell foul. But they just don't care about it. They think that, okay, it's nothing, every woman get that. So I think every woman should come up and take care of themselves, should love themselves, and also think, if they're there, their family is going to be there. They're the one who can take care the most of their family than anybody. So please, women, be careful and take care of yourself. Thank you.
Thanks, Payal, for the wonderful message. And now, the message from the man, Himanshu.
Thank you. Finally, I get my turn to speak something. First of all, thank you so much. I really appreciate it. You guys have invited. This is the first time I'm attending an event like this, which is hashtag She Self Help in Everything on the Women's Day. Thank you for this lovely slide of PCODs. My wife is suffering from that, so it really, really helps. So I was making those notes and I sent it to my wife and I told her, I said, baby, I'm learning PCODs for you. Sorry, I'll take your card then. And of course, thank you so much for the health and nutrition. It really helps because as an actor, all the time you're being visualized on the screen and fantasized by so many women, so you need to be very, very careful. Also, one of my crush was here, she just left, Bhagyashree, of course. And I just clicked a picture and I sent it to my social media team and I said, wow, I got a picture with my crush today, so please just post it immediately. And another thing, thank you, Alankrita, you have been fantastic. I think what you spoke deserves a big round of applause. Please give her a big round of applause. She's fantastic. I am overwhelmed by what you spoke. I think so many things she spoke I have recorded everything. Those 10 minutes have been wonderful because we have an organization called Share and Grow, where we provide a platform for people to come and share their experiences and help each other out. It would be my pleasure if ever we could have an invite. You know, you can really, really, really inspire. It comes from the heart, it comes from the soul, it comes from the experiences, it comes for whatever you have experienced over a period of time in your life. And it comes so strongly that it is definitely bound to touch people. So thank you so much for that. I mean, she really spoke very, very well about fear. And I think bahut hi zyada zaruri hai. I also keep saying this, kyunki fear ek aisi cheez hai jo bahut hi zyada hame jakad leta hai. I think the whole society is being curbed with that. Unfortunately, become very, very, very suppressed all the time because of so many things keep happening. So I always keep saying this, ki manzile unko milti hain jinke sapno mein jaan hoti hai. Pankhon se kuch nahi hota, hausnon se udaan hoti hai. So if we have the courage, I think that makes a huge difference. Baaki sab bekaar hai. Aur I think jis tarah ki society mein hum rehte hain na, if you become fearless na, I think you can achieve your goals. It's just because of the fear that you're stuck. So, self-help in everything. Help yourself. I mean, I will not take much of your time. It's a Women's Day. Women need to speak more. I will just leave. As it is, I came late, so I know a lot of people have been thinking, oh my God, this is the man we've been waiting for. I've been waiting for this all the time. No, let's not do that. So yes, absolutely not. I'm just going to take your leave. Thanks a ton for inviting me here. And just to all the women, please take care of yourself. I think no matter what people say, men are absolutely incomplete without women. I mean, I understand and I feel the kind of support my mother has given me. I understand and I feel the kind of support my wife gives me every day. Utne emotional strength, utne sensibilities, I think all those things that a lot of time men get stuck with a lot of things. Kuch samajh mein nahi aata. So I think, do ek do kaam aate hain, bibi aur maa. So yes, so thank you to all the wonderful women. And I'm just honored. Thank you so much for having me here. God bless you. Have a wonderful day. And happy Women's Day to everyone.
Thanks, Himanshu, for those wonderful words. Now, you know, since time is running out, you know, on behalf of Hinduja Healthcare Hospital, surgery.
वुमेन्स डे को लेके मतलब वुमेन्स को बहुत चीज़ें जानना ज़रूरी है. There need to be kind of awareness among women who live in remote villages. And apart from people living in remote villages who are not much aware of many things which is needed to be, they need to know. But there are women who are in urban women, and they themselves, even knowing everything, they don't take care of themselves. So this is very important. They need to take care of themselves and they need to love themselves, which will make them at least to go once in a year to a diagnostic center and go through all the tests, which is very important. My mom died of cancer, so I have been asked by doctors to go every once in a year to do ultrasonography, breast sonography, blood test, everything, because I have a history of cancer from my family. So, like, and even when my mom didn't have any cancer history in her family, but still she got that. So if we take care of ourselves, then maybe we could be diagnosed, even if it happens, we could be diagnosed in much prior state. So these are very important, very small things, but it really adds a lot.
I'll just say two lines and after that I'll leave. I think meri to thoda samajh se bahar hai, because I keep telling my wife also, and you know, we've been dating for almost, we've been together for 14 years. So thank you. Aaj ke zamane mein thoda mushkil hai.
Yeah.
So this going to the temple, and you know, when you're chumming, I mean, you have menses, I don't understand ki aap kyun nahi ja sakte. It's a biological system. Every woman is going through that. It's been happening since centuries. To meri samajh se bahar hai. Main is baat ko samajh bhi nahi pata kabhi, kyunki ek cheez jo upar wale ne diya aapko, jo biologically true hai, aap usko kuch nahi kar sakte. To why God doesn't say anything ki aap nahi aa sakte yaar. The prayer, the God resides in your heart. Then what do you do if the God resides in your heart? Agar dil mein aapke bhagwan hai, to phir aap mandir mein kyun nahi ja sakte? Mujhe aaj tak nahi samajh mein aaya. I mean, it's a very very tricky topic. I don't want to talk much about it because bahut sari cheeze aa jati hain, but I usually feel very, so that's why when you pointed out the topic to me on here, I was feeling, I said I wish somebody listens for you, because you're a woman, because hamari baat to koi sunega nahi. So at least do not do that. I mean, let them be yaar. I mean, I just can say please allow them. Hardly makes a difference, yeah. Yes. I just met my crush. Maine pyar kiya days. I mean, 1991. I was really, really young at that point of time. Of course, Bhagyashree ji, toh koi kehne wali baat nahi. Isliye maine kaha sabse pehle photo to khichwa lo unke saath. Usse pehle waise wo mujhe gussa kar rahe honge, main late aaya hu. But of course, she's a wonderful lady, and she looks as pretty and as sweet and as wonderful as she used to look in Maine Pyar Kiya. And the good part is, she worked with Rajshree. I'm doing my next film with Rajshree, so there's a small connection also here. I wish I could. Thank you so much. I wish I could tell it to her, but before that she left, so no problem at all. I'm so sorry, guys. I'm going to leave.
No problem.
Really nice to meet you. God bless you.
Thank you so much.
And
happy Wednesday to your wife.
Thank you. And please tag me on that.
What was your handle going to be like?
Himanshu Ashok Malhotra. Yours is Alankruta
Sahai.
Sahai. Perfect. Yeah. I'm going to do it. Thank you. Bye.
Thank
bye,
you.
Bye.
Puchi sawal puchi. धन्यवाद देखिए, सबसे पहले तो हमारे औरतों को एजुकेटेड होना बहुत ज़रूरी है. तो अगर आपके घर में लड़कियां हैं, उनको स्कूल भेजिए सबसे पहले तो, कि वो अपने आप को एजुकेट कर सकें. दूसरी चीज़, उनके हेल्थ, योर हेल्थ इज़ योर वेल्थ, हम कहते हैं, चाहे वो आदमी हो औरत हो. देयर शुड बी नो डिस्क्रिमिनेशन. आवर हेल्थ शुड नॉट बी सेकेंडरी. हेंस हेल्थ चेकअप्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. बट खाना, अच्छा न्यूट्रिशियस खाना भी औरतों का खाना बहुत ज़रूरी है. वी नीड टू ईट हेल्दी फैट्स, प्रोटीन्स, बिकॉज वी रिप्रोड्यूस, वी क्रिएट, वी नर्चर. यू हैव कम फ्रॉम अ वुमन, आप सब हैव कम फ्रॉम वुमेन. तो अगर आप एक औरत का ख्याल नहीं रखेंगे, वो अपना ख्याल सीख भी नहीं पाएंगे रखना, बिकॉज मे बी योर पेरेंट्स डोंट टीच यू दैट. मे बी आपके पेरेंट्स कहते हैं लड़के आगे बढ़ें, क्योंकि उनको घर चलाना होता है. पर आज के ज़माने में लड़कियां भी घर चला सकती हैं. दे आर एज कम्पेरेटिव, एज कॉम्पिटेंट एंड एज हार्ड वर्किंग एज मैन आर, बिकॉज वुमेन कैन हैंडल 10 थिंग्स. आप देखिए, औरतें काम पर जाती हैं, घर आके खाना बनाती हैं अपने हस्बैंड के लिए, बच्चों का ख्याल रखती हैं. वुमेन कैन मल्टी टास्क, बिकॉज देयर ब्रेन्स, देखा जाए साइंटिफिकली, कैन मल्टी टास्क इन डिफरेंट वेज. बट आई थिंक द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज़ औरतों को एक दूसरे को सपोर्ट करना चाहिए. हम क्या है, आप मीडिया वाले भी हैं, अगर आप देखते हैं अनुष्का ने किसी को ये कहा, ये किसी ने ये कहा, बट सेल्स, दिस इज़ मसाला. बट टू बी वेरी ऑनेस्ट, जनता जब ये देखती है कि दो औरतें जो इतने बड़े प्लेटफॉर्म पे हैं, जो चाहे इनके बीच में कोई दुश्मनी भी ना हो, बट इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कि हम ये दिखाएं कि वुमेन कैन बी फ्रेंड्स, वुमेन कैन लव ईच अदर, वुमेन कैन अपलिफ्ट ईच अदर. क्योंकि द पॉपुलेशन ऑफ वुमेन एंड द स्ट्रेंथ वुमेन हैव, दुर्गा माता, यू नो, सीता एंड लक्ष्मी. सो हम लक्ष्मी को ऐसे कैसे उजाड़ सकते हैं? तो ये बहुत ज़रूरी है कि लड़कियां सर उठा के जिए. आपने दंगल में देखा होगा, फिल्मों में आप देखते हैं कैसे उन्होंने अपनी दोनों बेटियों को, विदाउट ऑल द डिस्क्रिमिनेशन मिस्टर फोगट जी फेस्ड, उन्होंने अपनी बेटियों को किस लेवल पे, किस मुकाम तक. अब उनके ऊपर ट्रस्ट करना बहुत ज़रूरी है. द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज़ ट्रस्ट योर वुमेन, अपलिफ्ट योर वुमेन, लव योर वुमेन एंड गिव देम द फ्रीडम, गिव देम द टाइम टू ग्रो एंड नर्चर एंड एजुकेट देम. And their health is going to be your wealth, because who runs the world? Girls. So thank you so much, and happy Women's Day to all of you. And respect each other, please. That's most important. Respect. Thank you. थैंक यू।
देश और विदेश की हर तरह की न्यूज को हिंदी में सबसे पहले देखने के लिए हमारे चैनल लोकमत न्यूज हिंदी को सब्सक्राइब करना ना भूले।